All right. Shalom, shalom to all the elect. First off and foremost, all praises, honor, and glory due and goes to Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai. Call Halarim Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai, in which we do worship above all other worships and above everything else. All right. Double honors to the elder apostles who do rule well, who are the elder apostles of all Israel, and they're stationed out in New York City under the banner of GMS, all right, which we do worship. Y'all take that word and twist it however you want to, as in serve, nigga. That simple. Salutations to the elect, wherever you may be. I pray that this lesson is edifying to the elect out there. All right. Let's kick it off. Here's Romans 10. I'm starting with verse 2. For I bear them record that they have a zeal of Yahweh, but not according to knowledge. So you're going to have some guys out here that have fiery spirits, that it seems that they have the truth, or that they're in the truth, all right, as how they portray. And ultimately, these guys really think they have the truth. But what the next part say? For they being ignorant of God's righteousness, right, Yahweh's righteousness, all right, which that example is shown through men above you, all right, is shown through the elders. That's why you have examples. That simple, man. All right. For they being ignorant of Yahweh's righteousness and going about to establish their own righteousness. But you have a lot of niggas doing that, man. You know, the elders ain't got two elders going off, so I'm going to go do my own thing. So now you're establishing your own righteousness, doing your own thing, so to speak, man. Leaning to your own understanding, all right? Not taking into consideration that you may be going off, all right? Have not submitted themselves unto the righteousness of Yahweh. So these are unruly, unordered babes, man, all right? Because they have not submitted themselves to the righteousness of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai. What's the righteousness of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai? All right? Works, faith, this truth, all right? Because all that ties into one, man. But how are you taught that? Through men, through elders, who you're supposed to reverence, who you're supposed to serve, all right? Who you're supposed to worship. Geez, are you guys really tied up over the word worship? And don't make a video. You guys know what we saying. You niggas know what we saying. Never once did we say serve or worship or submit yourselves to the elders above Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai, man. But through them, we what? We get the truth, all right? Through them, we what? Preach the gospel. Through them, we what? Ultimately, through them, we are serving Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai by following their example, man. It's really that simple, man. You guys ain't got to follow our elders, man. And with that being said, I wonder who's watching over your souls, as the scriptures say, man. All right? 1 Timothy 1 and 6. From which some, having swerved, have turned aside unto vain jangling. A lot of you niggas are jangling niggas, man. Just vain talkings, man. Vain babblings, man. Just talking shit-ass niggas, man. And when a brother do come out and correct your damn doctrine with the right doctrine, with the correct breakdowns, all right, then, oh, it's nothing. Oh, you guys never broke that. Man, everything you brought out, we done broke down, man. Your ass just ain't listening, all right? That's all it is, man. And that's the exact fucking reason why we not into that debate thing. Yeah, debate thy cause with thy neighbor. That's simple, all right? But I'm going to debate with somebody that's willing to hear. Because everything we've told you and been telling you, we've been doing it. How many multiple times have you came over to the big house and we discussed certain things, man? How many times, man? I want you to count, man. How many times, man? So if you ain't gonna get it then, you ain't gonna get it now, man. It's pouring water into a broken vessel. You ain't gonna get it. You sitting up here talking about, well, this is show Israel. This is for y'all. Show y'all the righteousness of Yahweh. This is love, man. Not for me. Nah, nigga, if it really was that serious, Ock, you would have been came your ass down and debated, man. You was once a part of GMS, and you know how we get down. We don't go to them. They come to us. It's really that simple, man. Whatever. Desiring to be teachers of the law, understand neither what they say nor whereof they affirm. So a lot of you niggas don't even know what the fuck you talking about. You want to be a teacher so much. You want to be a prophet so much. You want to be so fucking deep. But you don't even know what the fuck you talking about, man. Right? You don't even understand it. All right? You guys are waxing worser and fucking worser. All right? And worse is not even a word. That's just how bad you guys are, man. Wax worse and worse. Oh, can the child say cock crew because the goddamn horn went off? Jeez. All right, this is 2 Peter 3 and 16. Also in his epistles being Paul, speaking in them of things in which some things are hard to be understood. All right, which Paul wrote about things that was hard to be understood, man. And let me name you some of them things, man. Like, as in now, some of the things that's hard to understand. Rape. The word worship. All right? Men bowing down to other men. Don't fucking hit me up and say, well, that's the Old Testament. We know it's the prophets and kings. Nigga, we still prophets. Elisha bowed to Elijah, man. All right? Nathan bowed to David. All right? It's that simple. And that was physically they did it. Was it going off? Was it going off? Because when you read Romans, things that are written aforetime was for our learning, man. All right? Those are examples of how humble your ass should be when you're talking to a man of the Lord, man. Anyway. Which they that are unlearned, so we ain't the unlearned. You are the unlearned. All right? And unstable rest. So it's your ass digging through these pages. Oh, let me find a deeper breakdown. Let me do this. Let me find a breakdown. No way, I'm telling you, being too deep is going to cause you to go into your own destruction, man. Right? As they do with other scriptures, unto their own destruction. So, nigga, it's y'all who going off and y'all can't see it. That's cool. If I gossip, we hear this head to them that's blind, man. Hell with you, niggas. All right? Constantly, we sit up here and tell you guys, you don't worship the elders above Yahweh Shemel Shai. All right, just because the elders say, well, you worshiping them is as worshiping Yahweh Shai. Well, that's scriptural, right? Like I keep on quoting, it says, when you have done the least unto them, you have done it unto me. So how much more on the flip side, man, as that scripture's going to, man? Feeding, clothing, giving these people the truth. It's the same as we doing it unto Yahweh Shai himself, man. So you guys don't understand the spiritual aspect of some of these scriptures, man. Niggas like to say context, context all the fucking time, but don't see the bigger picture, all right? Well, what about the wicked gods? Nigga, I know there's wicked gods. You one of them, nigga. All right? Don't use Acts 8 and 31 to say, well, he already knew. Of course he already knew the truth, all right? But he still needed to be built up, man. He still needed a man to guide him, all right? Because that does not defeat the purpose of Hebrews, the 5th chapter, man. Anyway. Let me get this off. This is 2 Timothy, the 3rd chapter. And really, it's the whole chapter, man. This know also that in the last days, perilous times should come. Which they coming, man. All right? They damn near upon us, man. Jacob's troubles, fucking hell, man. All right? For men should be lovers of them own selves. Because you can sit up and boast and say you're doing this shit for Yahweh Bashimi Avshah all you want to, man. We know what it really is, man. You a carnal ass nigga, man. All right? Carnal is all fuck, man. This is for your vain glory. Because that's how you act, man. All right? Lovers of their own selves, covetous, boasters, proud, blasphemers, disobedient to parents, man. I don't even have, you niggas already know what I'm talking about, man. I don't even really have to break that part down, man. Unthankful. You want to call us unthankful and ungrateful? Nigga, you must be out your rabbit ass lined up ass head, nigga. You must be, man. As much shit as me personally that I done for you guys, you out your damn mind. Don't you would ever fix your damn mouth to call me ungrateful, nigga. Ever. All right? Unthankful. Unholy. A lot of you niggas are profane, man. All right? Without natural affection. Truce breakers. You guys, hey, high treason on you niggas, man. False accusers. Incontinent. Fierce. Despisers of those that are good. A lot of you guys despise us and the elders, man. All right? Because give me one doctrine the elders broke down wrong, man. Don't use worship. We already did that, man. We already did that. All right? Don't use that. Don't use, what's the other one? Don't use masters. We already did that. Don't use parents or spiritual fathers. We've been there, done that, man. All right? Don't talk about the guides. We've been there, done that. It's y'all who don't understand. So I'm not going to continuously preach something that you don't understand for your sakes. If you don't get it, nigga, we moving on. It's that simple. Only reason why we do talk about you guys, because you guys probably said some shit and we correct. It's really the spirit that's on you. I don't think about you guys. All right? So if I fucking make a video, I'm going to use scriptures and I'm going to use points in the shit that you said, man. That none of you niggas could gainsay, man. Once at all, you cannot gainsay the shit that I've said, man. Through the spirit of Yahweh Bashimi Avshah. Because it's true. All right? Traitors. Heady. High-minded. Proud-ass niggas. Lovers of pleasures more than the lovers of Yahweh, man. Oh, Joseph was balling. All this. Listen, nigga, we know there was Israelites who had it back then. We know it's Israelites that got it now that's in the truth. That doesn't change anything, man. For you to sit up here and call the elders bums and they don't work. Listen, I personally called the elder Apostle Rakai and he was at work. He couldn't even really talk to me because he was at work. You know Elder Ramlat, Elder Apostle Gabal works, man. Same for Elder Apostle Taha, man. All right? You only met him once. Nigga, you only met him once. And I met Elder Ramlab and, Elder Manatazak, his name escapes me right now. Say Elder Ramlab, Elder Rakai. Yeah, Elder Rakai. All right? I met them multiple times. I just met Elder Apostle Taha and Elder Apostle Gabai once, and that's when I went to New York. And, nigga, you literally seen how they was living, how humble they was. Matter of fact, they worshipped you, as in served you, nigga. Like, yeah, how has thou fallen from heaven? I'm going to keep on saying that, man. Y'all niggas done filled right out the understanding of these scriptures, man. All right? But the night, having a form of godliness, like I was saying, you guys have a zeal, but what? But denying the power thereof. So you guys are denying Yahweh Bashimi Avshah. Although you say y'all worship Yahweh Bashimi Avshah, y'all praise Yahweh Bashimi Avshah, but how are you denying them? By talking shit against the men of the Lord, man. Alright? Talking fucking shit. Your ass wanna bring up all these women and sisters and mother scriptures. Nigga, we been knew that. Me and Benji did countless of videos on that topic, man. About how some women are in the truth, all right? How some women are part of the elect, as the scriptures say. Nigga, you old fucking news, dude. Anyway. But denying the power thereof from such turn away. So no, I don't want to have no fucking parts with you, man. It says from such turn away. Get the fuck away from me, man. Because if we talk and shit get heated, you already know what's probably going to happen, man. It ain't going to be shit nice. You do what the fuck you doing, and we going to do what we do. I'm going to say it like Joshua said it. I'm going to say it like Yahushua said it. As for me and my household, we should serve Yahweh by Shem Yahushua, man. All right? That's simple, man. For of this sort they have crept into houses and led captive silly women laden with sins. Since you want to talk about women so much, man. Led away with diverse lust, ever learning and not able to come to the knowledge of the truth. So guess what? You keep on reaching for all these deeper breakdowns and deeper understanding on this or that. Listen, man. Ever learning and not able to come into the simplicity of this truth, man. That simple. Don't fucking sit up on camera and say, yeah, we know it's man that God you unleashed. So it's you guys, huh? It's you guys. No, that's not how this thing started. And I'll get into that point of what I just said later in this video, man. All right? Now, as Janus and Jambres withstood Moses, so do these resist the truth. Y'all niggas are doing the exact same shit that wicked-ass two-third niggas did in the past, man. Oh, surely Yahweh's dealing with us, too. Surely we got the truth, too. Surely Yahweh's revealing secrets unto us, too. It's an order, my nigga. And y'all have not yet realized that there is an order. You went off on that. There ain't no order on earth. There ain't no order on earth. Listen, the governing body that's going to govern in heaven, some of the men are sitting here on this earth today, right, in that same stead, right? It's you niggas that's fighting against it, man. You know what you niggas should do? Follow Acts. If this thing be of God, you're going to find yourself fighting against your how about Shem Yahushua. You're going to find yourself kicking against the pricks. But guess what? If it ain't of Yahweh, it's going to fall apart, man. See, that's why I don't worry about you niggas, man. All right? Because if you niggas ain't right, the Lord's going to break that shit up anyway, man. But that ain't happening with GMS, man. All right? Because to all you guys that call yourselves Israelites, and this is to everybody that calls themselves Israel, out of all the doctrines that's out here, who's preaching the correct one? All right? Because it's either a nigga ain't preaching the name or the nigga ain't preaching the mark of the beast. And GMS preach both of those. And other and certain other camps, although they don't go under the banner of GMS, they follow that doctrine. All right? And you niggas know very damn well who got the truth out here, man. And don't make a dumbass statement. Well, if y'all really have the truth, everybody will flock to y'all. Everybody will come to y'all, so to speak. Nigga, that ain't what the scriptures say, man. All right? Most people are going to reject this truth, then flow unto it, man. That's what I mean. Constantly, every week, you niggas put crusty-ass bunions and toes in your mouth. All right? Y'all put y'all fucking foot in y'all mouth daily, man. From the shit y'all say, man. And I don't even want to start about certain comments, man. Which proved to me how simple a lot of you niggas are, man. So do these also resist the truth? Men of corrupt mind, reprobate, reprobate concerning the faith. All right, reprobate concerning the faith. But they should proceed no further. Like I said, Yahweh Shem Yahushua gonna shut a lot of shit down, man. For their folly should be manifest unto all men, as theirs also were it was. So guess what? Your folly is going to be manifested, right? It's going to come out to show that you're fucking wrong. And like I said, something gonna happen, man. I'm telling you. Crew messenger gonna come out of nowhere when you least expect it and fuck one of y'all up, man. Remember, every idle word you niggas gotta account for, man. The mad shit talking that I've heard when you guys were a part of this camp. Talk, and you know what? You guys can't deny that. Especially you, Nazarite. How much shit have you talked about certain brothers, man? I can only imagine the shit you said behind my back. All right? If you're gonna be a real nigga, say the shit in the nigga face, man. Don't sit up and talk shit behind a brother back for months. And then when we do, you know, my annual barbecue, want to sit up there and cry in the kitchen and hug Uriah and say, oh, this is my teacher, everybody. This is y'all teacher. But talk the most shit behind his back, man. That's where James coming to play at, man. Blessings and curses, man. All right? Now, I'm not saying you curse the brother or whatnot, but still, bitter and sweet waters don't come out the same, bitter and sweet water don't come from the same place, man. All right? Don't talk shit behind a brother back, and then when you see him and you're in front of everybody, when you're in front of 50 or 60 men that's in my house, want to sit up there and fucking cry and say that Uriah is your teacher, man. He's your teacher, man. And turn around a couple of days after that, start talking shit once again, man. Hey, listen. How about Shimmy Out Shine the Angels? No, nigga. All right? That's something you got to deal with. Anyway, back to the scriptures. But they shall proceed no further. For their folly should be manifest unto all men, as theirs also was. But thou hast fully known my doctrine, manner of life, purpose, faith, long-suffering, charity, patience, persecutions, afflictions, which came unto me in Antioch. So, let's take that for account now. Y'all know all the things that the elder apostles went through. Y'all know. At, Iconium in Lystra, what persecutions I endured. But out of all of them, the Lord delivered me. Yea, and all that will live godly in Mashiach Yahweh shall suffer persecutions. But evil men and seducers, which a lot of you niggas are, shall wax worse and worse. Which, that's going on. Deceiving and being deceived. The deceived and the deceiver is his, man. You guys are in a fucking trap. You guys are in a trap bag, man. How about Shimmy Avshai got you guys in a snare? Alright? That prayer that Dawah did, that Pilar that Dawah did, when he said, let thy table become a snare and a trap unto them. These scriptures have become a snare and a trap to a lot of you niggas, man, that call yourself Israelites, man. All right? Now, what does it say? But continue thou in the things that thou hast learned. So what was y'all supposed to do? Continue in the things that y'all have learned. Because if the elders ain't got it now, please drop everything you learned, nigga. Please drop it all. Drop it all. All right? Drop it all, man. But continue thou in the things that thou hast learned and being assured of whom, being assured of knowing of whom thou hast learned them. In that form. So y'all should know who and where y'all got the truth from, man. And y'all are supposed to continue in that doctrine. All right? But oh well. Somebody got to play a rebellious role. Somebody got to be a wicked ass nigga. Somebody got to be the two-thirds. Somebody have to fall out the truth, man. Somebody has to separate or be kicked out from a group of men. And that's scriptural, nigga, like I said. Second part of this video, I'm going to go into that. All right? And from a child that has known the holy scriptures, which are able to make thee wise unto salvation through faith, which in Mashiach Yahweh Shai, which is in Mashiach Yahweh Shai. All scripture is given by inspiration of Yahweh, and is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, for instruction in righteousness. So that's why we get on a lot of you niggas, man. All these scriptures are examples for us of what to do. Instruction, doctrine, reproof, correction. But as we can see, a lot of you guys can't take reproof or correction, man. It's that simple. Like you niggas can talk shit about me all you want. Rat tail this, rat tail that, mush mouth this, that. I don't give a fuck, man. I don't. Because it's you niggas who getting cut, and it's going to be you niggas standing on the wrong side of the sword in that fucking day, man. And like I said, don't fuck yourself and say, well, you act like you part of the election. You have to say, make thy calling an election sure, nigga. All right? So I'm going to preach this word as if I was part of the elect. Not saying, oh, I'm part of the elect, but I'm going to preach it and go about it as if I am. And still humble myself at the same time, man. All right? Now, about Shimmy Outshy, give you examples and give you certain instructions of what to do to actually be a part of the elect. But ultimately, it's about if you've written in that book of life or not, man. That's what it boils down to. If Yahweh actually chose you. All right? That the man of Yahweh may be perfect, thoroughly furnished unto all good works, man. And who've been doing the good works for years, man? You sit up and say, oh, you done messed up a lot of brothers' minds. No, the brothers that minds did get fucked up, they wasn't a part of it anyway, man. All right? There's a lot of sifting going on around these parts, man. All right? And y'all and you niggas got sifted right into that shit, man. All right? Maybe it's you that's going around fucking up a lot of brothers' minds, teaching them how to fucking rebel, man. All right? You fucking witch. I ain't even going to call you a wizard, man. I'm going to give you a feminine version of it. You fucking witch. All right? You shameless dog. Kaka kalab, man. All right? You break that down, nigga. Ah, so here we go. Galatians 1 and 6. I marvel that ye are so soon removed from him that called you into grace, into the grace of Mashiach, unto another gospel. So, you gotta understand, it ain't people leaving your fucking group or your doctrine. It ain't people being removed from that set. All right? Strike one. You ain't got it right there alone, man. Because that ain't you. You don't fit that description, man. Which is not another. But there be some that trouble you and will pervert the gospel of Mashiach. You claim that we pervert the gospel, or we've been perverting the gospel. Even when your ass was with us, man. Right? Was we perverting the gospel then? So not too long ago, you broke down that masters, a servant to be subject to your masters, as in being the elders. But now it's not, man. Alright? Now you're perverting the gospel of Mashiach. So you were removed. You were removed. You were casted away. You were kicked out. Not the other way around. So strike one. This can't be talking about your ass when it comes to the group and then the other people leaving. You are part of the people leaving. You ain't a part of that group. All right? All right, this is Philippians 3 and 17. Brethren, be followers together of me. Oh, shit. You aren't supposed to be following man. I'm Tzalakiak. I brought off the wrong scripture. So, this is how stupid you niggas sound, man. Brethren, be followers together of me, and mark them which walk so as ye have us for example. So, you're supposed to, scopeo? You're supposed to look at a man like that, man. Observe a man like that, man. Learn from his ways, man. But we don't supposed to have no guides. You aren't supposed to have no leaders, man. Shut the fuck up, man. From Shapatya to you, just shut the fuck up. All that rah, rah, rah shit don't work with me. Whatever, nigga. Just talk that little bullshit you want, man. Fuck up, man. Brethren, be followers together of me, and mark them which also, or so, Salakia, which walk so as ye have us for example. For many walk of whom I told you often, and now tell you even weeping. So when this whole shit started to go down, the shit was kind of heartbreaking for me. But I had to gird up my loins like a man and let shit be. Because ultimately, you're still doing the same shit, man. You have not learned, right? Even if the elders was wrong, man, you still didn't suffer it patiently. Like, nigga, that Second Peter's, how many times, Nazariah, did I quote you that Second Peter's, man? Huh? Then you don't fucking turn around. Oh, I was crying on your couch because I fought with y'all for 4 years. And y'all turned y'all backs on me. Nah, nigga, ain't nobody turn your backs on. We ain't turn our back on you, nigga. You went off. And all right, then, nigga, if that's the case, don't sit up there and admit that, oh, you know what, I did went off. Don't say that shit, because now you lying, nigga. So did you go off or you didn't? Nigga, be a fucking man. Be a fucking man, Nazariah. All right, because I remember every fucking peon word you told to me, man. Fuck out of here, man. Anyway, it says, for many walk, whom I have told you often, and now tell you even weeping, that they are the enemies of the cross of Mashiach. You niggas are enemies, man. All right? Don't use that Sirach. Rejoice not over that greatest enemy when he fall. I didn't rejoice over you niggas. At all. At all. I just put a curse up and said, if you niggas ain't of the elect, man, it's going to stick. Regardless, man. If I ain't of the elect, it's going to stick. Like, what y'all don't understand about that shit, man? Whose end is destruction? So the scriptures say your end is destruction, man. If you stay on that path, your end is destruction, nigga. All right? Who power is their own belly? Whose glory is their own shame? Who mind earthly things? Balling up. I'm going to be balling up. Balling up. Listen, nigga. I already gave you the skinny on me, nigga. All right? I don't give a fuck how much shit I got in fucking Babylon. It's not balling, man. This shit is captivity. Even if you think a nigga is well off, all right? This shit is captivity to me. I don't give a fuck, man. I don't give a fuck that I got a 6-bedroom house with 3-4 bathrooms and a jacuzzi. That don't mean shit, all right? Or 2 cars, about to get 3 cars. That don't mean shit, I. It never did. Never did, man. Fuck this shit, man. I ain't about to be stronghold on some shit that's temporal. Fuck out of here, man. 1 Timothy 4:4. Now the Spirit speaketh expressly that in the latter times, which we are in, some should depart from the faithful. Yeah, you niggas are, man. Giving heed to seducing spirits and doctrines of devils. So that means a certain men are going to leave a certain group or get kicked out a certain group and start falling into other bullshit. Although they claim they have the truth, they're going to start falling into other doctrines. Now, you put the shoe on if it fits, man. Because that happened with GMS and you niggas are fucking going about other shit now, man. All right? All you niggas that fucking fell out or got casted away, man. All right? And I ain't just talking about this group here in Chicago, wherever the fuck you may be, man. Speaking lies in hypocrisy, man. Speaking lies and hypocrisy, man. A lot of you niggas are some of the biggest hypocrites I've ever seen or met. Having their conscience seared with a hot iron. Ain't no coming back from that, man. You niggas are tagged, sold, and gone, man. That simple. Galatians 5:7. Ye did run well. A lot of you niggas did a good job, you know, starting off running well in this truth. Look good. Look like you was a man of the Yahweh Shemel Shai. Ye did run well, who did hinder you that you should not obey the truth. This persuasion cometh not of him that calleth you, all right? Because guess what? That's why, Satan got you niggas, man. And guess what? I'm going to deliver a lot more of you niggas to Shaitan, man. Hell with you guys, man. A little leaven leaveth the whole lump. Hey, before GMS turned lumpy, we had to get rid of that leaven. And we got rid of that leaven during Passover. So, did Yahweh Bashim Yahshua make a mistake, nigga? Anyway, it says, I have confidence in you through Adonai that ye will be none otherwise minded. You're supposed to be otherwise minded. Took them away with these different doctrines, man. But he that troubleth you shall bear his judgment, whosoever he may be. Hey, so you who's troubling brothers that's just coming in, you're going to bear that judgment, man. And I, brethren, if I yet preach circumcision, why do I yet suffer persecution? Then is the offense of the cross cease. Which Paul is getting into part, well, you know, a debate or, you know, a feud going back and forth on whether we should have circumcision or not. So he's saying, shit, if I preach circumcision, why am I still getting prosecuted, you know? Because, listen, you can't please these two-third-ass niggas, all right? Then he further says, then is the offense of the cross ceased. Then there would have been no point if Yahweh Shai dying on that cross, man. I would that they were even cut off which trouble you. So, Paul, hey, I hope that you niggas die. I hope that you niggas ain't around us, man. All right? Because you guys are troubling to us, man. For brethren, ye have been called into liberty. Only use not your liberty for occasion to the flesh. All right? So, it's certain things we have liberty to do in this truth and in this world. Right? But don't use it to on an occasion to please your damn flesh, man. All right? It's that simple. It's many examples of things you should do and things you shouldn't do. Although some things are lawful, it's certain things that ain't expedient during this time and in this setting. All right? It says, for brothers, ye are called into liberty. Only use not liberty for occasion to the flesh, but by love serve one another. Serve one another. Look up that word serve, man. All right? Look up that word serve, man. All right? Because that's all we were saying when we broke down the word worship, man. We serve one another. We worship one another. Right? Yahweh Shai served the disciples. He worshiped the disciples. Y'all niggas just bugged out on words, man. Anyway, for all this law is fulfilled in one word, even in this: thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. Right? Thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. If ye bite and devour one another, take heed that ye. It says, take heed that ye be not consumed one another, man. Which, that's why you got to cast certain brothers away, man. All right? You're supposed to love your brother as thyself, not treat him like shit, man. All right? Not put him down all the fucking time, man. All right? Because it says, but if you bite and devour one another, which a lot of you niggas are doing now and you're trying to do, all right? Take heed that ye be not consumed one another, man. All right? So don't let this shit consume you, man. All right? Which a lot of you niggas let this thing consume you, man. Niggas want to go tick for tack back and forth. Listen, if I make a video, it's purely for edification, man. All right? Because we do have to warn Israel. And listen, fuck all Israel. All right? I'm say that, man. We got to warn the elect from niggas like y'all, man. That's simple. That's the only reason why we do what we do, man. 2 Peter 1:5. And besides this, give all diligence. Add to your faith virtue. And virtue, knowledge. A lot of you niggas ain't got virtue, man. And to knowledge, temperance. A lot of you niggas ain't got temperance. And to temperance, patience. A lot of you niggas ain't got patience. And to patience, godliness. A lot of you niggas ain't got godliness. All right? And godliness, brotherly kindness. A lot of you niggas ain't got that. Let's just be honest. All right, for if these things be in you and abound, they make you that ye should never be barren nor unfruitful in the knowledge of Adonai Yahweh Shai Mashiach. But he that lacketh these things is blind. So you niggas that's lacking these things are blind leaders. You're blind bandits, man. Blind rebels. That's you niggas, man. All right, and cannot see afar off. For a nigga to say, in the time of Jeremiah, the testimony of Yahweh Shai wasn't around. Nigga, what's the testimony of Yahweh Shai? It's the spirit of prophecy. It's prophecies all through Jeremiah, nigga. That's what I mean, nigga. Some of this shit you say is obsolete. It's stupid. It's redundant. Damn. And have forgotten that he was purged of his own sins. Wherefore, the rather, brethren, give diligence to make your calling and election sure. So that's what I'm doing now, man. No, I'm not, I'm part of the elect, everybody. No, but I'm going to carry that persona, all right? I'm going to do this work as if I'm fighting for that prize, man, because that's what I really want. It says, wherefore, brothers, give diligence to make your calling and your election sure. For if you do these things, ye should never fail. So if you do those things that Yahweh Shimi Yahweh Shai said, the scripture ain't no lie, man. All right, Yahweh Shimi Yahweh Shai is not a man that he should lie. All right? It says, if you do these things, you should never fail, man. Which means you're going to be a part of the elect. If you do these things, you should never fail, man. A lot of you niggas ain't doing those things, man. And let's just be honest. If you really want to talk about scriptures, if this thing ain't about no strife and contentment, you guys know where to find me. And you know how to contact me. Let's not play no fucking games, man. If you really about your how about Shimmy Out Shy, act like it, man. Act like it, nigga. Because if not, you just put it on a fucking show, man. And that's what I mean by vainglory, man. You can sit up there and say, that ain't about me. Yeah. Hey, actions speak louder than words, my dude. You know that better than anybody. Right? And one thing you know, anything you say, I search the scriptures to make sure I ain't going off or make sure it ain't going off. I've done did my research. I've done dug through the data, man. I done dug through the elders. I done dug through these other camps. I done dug through the brothers that's next to me to see what's what and what's not, man. And I know what it is. You guys ain't got it, man. You guys are not the elders. All right? This thing was not built on your foundation, man. This thing started and was built with Yahweh Shimei Yahshai in the order that that is set up by Yahweh, man. That simple, man. Not you Johnny come lately niggas. I really want you brothers of that sect. All you fucking scoffers. Listen, we're going to have scoffers anyway, man. Consider what you actually doing, man. You do that, man. Consider what you actually doing, man. That's what y'all need to do, man. Consider what you actually doing. If y'all don't understand it, that's on y'all, man. That ain't on us. Don't get mad because y'all ain't got it. Don't get mad because y'all can't be in order. Don't sit up and tell a brother to hold his peace. Order, order. There ain't no order on earth. What type of shit is that, man? Then a lot of your followers, flunkies or however the fuck, like whatever, man. A lot of them niggas are simple. And you know what? You know they simple, man. Because I run circles around you and them. Through the spirit of Yahweh Shimei Yahweh Shai. We've been giving out countless of lessons and scriptures of where y'all going off and what is right. But y'all don't see it. It's not my job to make y'all see it. If Yahweh Shimei Yahweh Shai doesn't increase you or let you understand that, you take that up with him and see what happened, man. You talking about y'all need to repent. Listen, brother, you need to repent, man. You need to turn back from your fucking way that you're doing now, man. And guess what? Like I said, you think what you're doing is right. You really do. There's a way that seemeth right unto the man, but the end thereof is death. Consider that, man. Consider that, man. Because when this shit come to an end, Yahweh Shimei Yahweh Shai gonna lay havoc on all you niggas that talk shit against the men of the Lord, the apple of his eye. You niggas are gonna suffer, man. You niggas are going to suffer. And let me tell you guys, Elder Apostle Rakai repented for a lot of the things he did, man. Just because you don't see it on camera or it wasn't a public apology, it happened. You guys don't think the Elder Apostles went in or rebuked them, you niggas out your mind, because they did. That's because it ain't no, everything ain't got to be done on camera, man. It don't. So consider that, man. Since you guys want to be all hasty and pasty, man. Consider that, man. Because none of you niggas went into the scriptures that we brought out. Everything you asked for, right? We done went into. Only thing I personally didn't go into yet is Wisdom of Solomon 17. Which I already told y'all was breaking down. If y'all want me to do a video on it, I'll do it. When the spirit jump on me to do it, I'll do it. Another brother already did it. Right? The elders already went into it, man. Right? Everything y'all done brought out, I personally went into. Right? Your Revelations 19 and 10. Been into that. Right? Because that Greek word is the same word for Revelations 3 and 9, man. Alright? So, Israelites will be bowing down to other Israelites in the kingdom of heaven, right? Israelites bow down to other Israelites on this side, man. Ain't no getting around that. And don't say, well, it's because respect and honor. We still show respect and honor on this side, man. Nigga. With that, I'm going to say all praises, honor, and glory to Yahweh Shem Yahushai. All right, call Halayim, Yahweh Shem Yahushai. Double honors to the elder apostles of all Israel, which do rule well. All right? Salutations to them. Double honors to them. Salutations to the elect, wherever you may be. I pray that this was edifying. With that, shalom to the elect, man. Shalom, which is a little encore, man. All right? A little food for thought. Just 3 to 4 months ago, a nigga would call me and say, I watched this video a lot. Multiple brothers. I watched this video a lot. You know, yo, you looking good out there. You looking on fire. Oh, y'all brought GMS 26 back. You looking good. But now everything we saying is fucking off, man. I've been preaching the same thing I've been preaching since I woke up, man. Ain't shit changed, man. Ain't nothing changed. But yet, now we ain't got it. Now we flunkies. Now we wicked. You niggas don't amaze me, man. At all. At fucking all, man. At all, man. I really mean that. Because it was a couple months ago, it was all shalom. How about you, man? Shalom, rock and die. Now it was this. Nigga, I've been saying the same shit over and over. So guess what? You should have been saying them things back then, man. All right? But with that, man. Thus is the words of this prophet ended. Shalom to the elect, man.